So now that we have seen an example of exception handling with ROB, let's do an exceptions with ROB quiz. So let's say that we have these instructions in program order. So this is the order in which they are supposed to execute according to the programmer. Let's say that this is the current status of this instruction. The add is committed, meaning it has exited the pipeline and its results have been committed from the ROB to the register file and so on. The load is executing, meaning it has left the reservation station, it is now doing its thing, and the result still hasn't been broadcast on the bus, and the load has not committed yet. This add is done, which means that it got the reservation station, it exited the reservation station, computed its result, deposited the result somewhere, but the result is still not committed, meaning the add still hasn't left the processor. The divide is also executing like the load here, meaning it has read these registers and now it's slowly computing its result. This add is done, meaning it has computed its result, but it still hasn't committed, and this add is also done. Let's say that this divide, when the status of these instructions is like this, has an exception. So while it's executing, we discover, for example, that it's been trying to divide by zero. So this add now has an exception. The question for you is, what is the new status of these instructions after this exception has been handled? Meaning, what is the new status at the point at which we can go to the exception handler?